It was 30 years ago that the Texas Parks and Wildlife television series, originally known as Made in Texas, got its start. Bruce Biermann is one of more than 30 producers, photographers, writers, and editors who have contributed to the show since its first broadcast in 1985.
My name is Bruce Biermann, and I've been with the television series for 24 years as a producer. One of my favorite stories is called The Black Bears of Black Gap. I was following two of our biologists as they did a study of black bears out in West Texas. One of the bears that they captured, I was able to be there for that event. And when the bear was knocked out and they were processing it, studying it, I had finally recorded enough and I put down the camera. I said, "Can I touch the bear?" And they're like, "Yeah, sure." I never thought in my wildest dreams I'd be able to touch a black bear, let alone, because it was knocked out, I was able to get down and smell its breath as it was breathing, and it was snoring. What a wonderful life experience. The biologists in this story are husband and wife, and they are a hoot.
Yeah, that scat looks like it's got corn or something in it. It's so mushy.
So I hope you enjoy this story. I really enjoyed producing it.
I'm Bonnie McKinney, and I live on the Black Gap Wildlife Management Area, which is down along the Mexican border.
Mama Bear has moved. Maybe make a complete circle around, but maybe she's right back in there. It's very faint.
We have a research project going on here on the Black Gap Wildlife Management Area. We have seven bears collared.
Got her.
Yeah, he's right there.
Yeah. You can just swing back around there again.
A natural recovery by any wildlife species, very seldom does it naturally recover without man helping it along. And the bears have just literally decided to make West Texas their home again and are actually moving back into this country from northern Mexico. So it's up to us to kind of help them in any way that we can, and we need to learn something about these bears. Look over there, what's that on? Wait, what's that on the ridge? Stop, look.
I think it's on top because...
Yeah, she's right on the top. It's where she's at. She's right on the top.
You see her?
No, but I can hear her. You can put the antenna right
here. We're studying home range, diet, habitats, mortalities, and we also want to be able to provide management techniques for private landowners that are now finding themselves living with a black bear in West Texas. Some of our colleagues and peers, they sort of look at you and say, "You don't really have black bears on Black Gap, do you?" Well, yeah, we've got seven bears collared. "Oh, come on, you know, what do they eat?" Well, they eat Spanish dacker and sotol and yucca, and they sort of shake their head and say, "It's just amazing, we can't believe that." Well, come down, visit the study site, and we'll take you out.
Get this gate up and set, we can catch bear.
Bonnie does a lot of different things. She does a lot of cactus surveys and bird work. Right now, a lot of stuff is taking Bonnie's time up is this bear research program that's going on in the Black Gap Wildlife Area right now.
Well, I'm the boss, but he bosses.
And sometimes there's little deals, you know, like you go do this, and they'll say, "Well, I don't work for you." And
we get along.
You know how marriage is.
Well, we've lived on the Gap almost 20 years. And there's kind of a joke. When we moved to the Gap, he said, "Oh, you'll love over there. There's lots of trees. Lots of water." Well, you couldn't get more desert than Black Gap. So actually, we met on the Black Gap.
You can look around here, and there's not a lot of women in this country, so you you make opportunities where you can.
I guess you could say charmed me.
I actually caught her stealing cactus, you know.
I mean, you know, life sentence. I try to make the best of it here, so.
It's not always peaches and cream, that's for sure.
He really didn't charm me, guys.
Bonnie's a strong-willed person. I'm set in my ways, and
it's really been a life sentence. We love the solitude out here. If we get in an argument, we can certainly scream our heads off and not worry about the neighbors hearing about us, but.
It's actually about 85 miles to an area where you can get a good selection of groceries and things, and that's an hour and a half drive one way. And that's an extra $20 added onto your food bill.
also disagree on a lot of things, but being a husband and wife, we work it out.
Yeah, it can be crazy and different working with your wife, but it's really a good job.
Bye. The bears move around till about 11 o'clock when it gets real hot, so we go check traps early in the morning. Okay, this is a fun part of bear trapping, resetting the barrels. The guys have refused to crawl in here on their tummies and rebait for me. Okay, I'm gonna use a commercial bait. It's a strawberry flavored bait. Ouch. Bear comes in here, he can't resist it. They love sweet stuff. He'll flip this little trigger and he tries to get this bait bag and we catch a bear. You see a bear out here in this country and they've been gone so long, and then to have them back, it's a pretty incredible deal. And it's also putting back a part of Texas that was gone, that we thought was gone forever. They're back.
Come on out and bring those drugs as quick as you can. I'm en route. We got a bear in a tree up in Alpine. I need that stuff.
10-4, we're on our way. We just got a call from Alpine that there's a bear in a tree at Alpine, and I've got the drug kit with me. Bill is en route, and Don's gone up to pick up the covert trap. So we are on the way.
10-4, come in right behind you.
She should stay up the tree, hopefully. And we'll dart her, then probably get her down with ropes. Get out of the way. Move back, please. Wait a minute, you gotta mix it.
I got it mixed right here.
Oh, okay.
Hold this right here.
How big is that bear? He's right there?
He's an adult bear.
Okay. You want to, if he falls, you want to put him in a tarp?
And I was up fooling around in the yard, and I looked up in this tree, and there was a bear in the tree. So I go in and tell my wife, and she didn't believe me, of course. She had to come out and look.
Good shot. Well, he'll go down in a minute. He's in a perfect tree, because when he falls, he'll just hit those branches and it'll break his fall all the way down. Okay, y'all get back a little bit. We're gonna drop him down. We're gonna attempt to drop him down.
Ready? Hang on.
That's a big bear. Oh. Take that magnet off.
This is cool.
You gotta touch him?
No. Y'all need to stay back. Bears are all wild animals. They're not. Okay, I need tip of his nose. Right on the tip.
Down the middle.
Right down the middle center of his back. We need more tape. Babe, we need to get that blood. Ear tagging. Okay.
We put the tracking collars on these bear because we want to determine their home ranges and compare it to other studies in the United States. I expect us to find some pretty exciting information out. And without the tracking collars, we wouldn't know as much about what was going on, especially about individual animals.
Collar's plenty loose. He's snoring. We have a wet towel.
Daddy
snores.
He does.
What do you guys think we should call this bear, huh?
Let's Big bear.
Really
Black bear.
No, come
Big
on.
Bear. Papa bear.
Come
Big
on.
Bear.
Blue. You have to get him Big something bear. To wake him up or what?
No, this drug is a drug that's really good for bears. He'll wake up, he'll be really groggy and...
Whoa. He's not really a problem bear. Really didn't do any damage or tear anything up. It's just that we really moved him for his protection, not for people's protection.
wasn't a problem bear or nuisance bear. So there's no problem with him going anywhere as far as, I mean, he's not a problem. But we'll monitor his movement. A lot of times a relocated bear doesn't stay in the area that you put him in. So we'll get out and do lots of ground telemetry in the next couple of days with this big guy.
Okay, what we got here is a rope tied to our guillotine gate so we can let this bear loose without anybody being around it for safety reasons, and also because he might come out a little better if he's not anybody standing around open the gate. Well, all we gotta do is turn him loose now.
If he'll stay in here, we'll be up. I'll come up early in the morning and run telemetry on him, see what he's doing. He'll probably sleep off pretty much the rest of the afternoon. It's almost a comforting feeling to know that black bears are out here in this country, and they're moving around at night, they're feeding, they're raising their young, after being gone for so long, that they're actually coming back.
It kind of soothes my soul, if you will say, that this animal has come back. Basically, he's done it on his own. Hopefully, we can give him some help to go ahead and finish his expansion into historic range. But to me, it just is a good feeling. I really think that a lot of people are going to get that same feeling, that we have this animal here, and that maybe we're doing something right on wildlife management area to have this animal here.